Thank you very much, Asma, for lovely invitation. In this topic, I will discuss about hybrid API management and API microgateways everywhere. So my name is Sanjeewa Malalgoda. I am working for WSO2 for about last 8 years. And in my role, I am primarily working with WSO2 API manager team, and I am leading research and development effort of WSO2 API manager team. So today in this session, we will discuss about API management and different API management components. And after that, we will discuss about different deployment strategies. Under that, we will cover on-premise deployment, cloud deployment, and also hybrid cloud API management deployment. And also, we will discuss about advantages and disadvantages of each deployment methodologies. Then after that, we will discuss a little bit about role of microgateway that plays in hybrid API management deployment. And then after that, we will discuss what WSO2 API Manager microgateway and how it works and that kind of information. So if we discuss about API management, I'm sure you all know about what API management is, and you have a very clear idea about what API management and how different API management solutions work and that kind of information. But just for the completeness and the people who join in the middle, for their awareness, I will briefly discuss about this as well. So as you can see here, in our right side, we have services and data. In our left hand side, we have people. So these people need to consume the services and data available in the right side. So they will use applications to consume that services and data. So they will do that through the applications. So this application need to consume services and data. So these services and data may have some sensitive information. So we do not expose them in direct way. And we need to expose them in a controlled and more secured way. So that is where API management and integration comes into picture. And these services and data may be stored in a way that directly cannot consume from the applications. So in such cases, lightweight mediation and different integration and message transformation and that kind of implementations also will help. So for example, your service may expose data in a JSON format, but your apps need to consume in XML format. So in such case, API management and integration solution should capable to handle that kind of lightweight message transformation as well. So usually, API manager gateway and gateway plays very important role in API management story. So basically, when applications invoke these APIs or services, they will send some kind of a security metadata, which helps API gateway to identify who sent this request and apply certain quality of services such as security, rate limiting, integration, and analytics kind of thing. So gateway is mainly responsible for validate this request and apply quality of services. Okay, so before moving to deployment, I will quickly go through different components of API management solution. So these six components are the major six components available in WSO2 API Manager. So this is not only common to WSO2 API Manager solution. So if you take any other API management solution, most of these components present in their solutions as well, maybe in a different name or different version of same component. So if we discuss about publisher, it is basically backend application, and it allows API creators to create API. So it is the place where we go and create APIs and manage complete API lifecycle. So basically, this component interact with API publishers and creators, and it helps us to create APIs and govern them. Then comes developer portal. So developer portal is the place which API consumers use heavily. So for example, if you're an application developer and you need set of APIs to your application, then you will have to come to developer portal and search for whatever the APIs that you required, and you can start consuming this. So if we consider WSO2 API Manager developer portal, it has capability to search for APIs and read the documentation. And also, if need, you can build some kind of a knowledge base by using the discussion forum. So you can participate discussions and you can initiate discussions related to your APIs. Those features available in the developer portal. So next one, gateway. I discussed about that before. So this is primarily acting as a policy enforcement point. So it will enforce certain security throttling kind of policies. And whenever request comes to authenticate an authorization, authorized purpose, it will communicate with the key management server. So key manager's primary responsibility is to communicate with API gateway. And key manager will authenticate and authorize all the incoming API requests. So next component is analytics. API gateway collects some metadata related to message that are incoming. Then it will push that event to analytics server. So analytics server will process this information and summarize them as useful stats to API creators and publishers. So with that, you can see what happens to your API, what are the different traffic patterns, at what time of the day your API is invoked heavily. That kind of information you can collect with the analytics. Next component is the traffic manager. So traffic manager mainly responsible for traffic shape up of your API gateway. So traffic manager closely work with API gateway. Whenever request comes to gateway, it will verify whether gateway should process this one or not. And traffic manager is the component that asks gateway to take that decision. So for example, if you have some requirement to limit API access to like 100 API calls per minute, so traffic manager is the component which keep this counter and apply this throttling rules. So this is how different users interact with API management story. So like I said, we have API developers, and they will interact with the publisher. They will manage API lifecycle. So once we've done the deployment, that API will go to API gateway or micro gateway. Then API developers or app developers will come into developer portal. They will start consuming this API. Then finally, API consumers will use this API through the gateway. So this gateway can communicate with microservice, web service, or it can be some kind of ESB service, which connect to multiple backend services. And by the time gateway validate the request, it will communicate with the key manager, like I mentioned earlier, and also it communicate with the traffic manager. Then after authentication and authorization purpose, it will push even to real-time and batch analytics, which generate itself and events to external users. So now, with the basic understanding about API management and different component in the API management story, we will move into deployments. So first deployment methodology is the on-premise API deployment, API management deployment. So in this case, what we will do is we will discuss, we will deploy all the six components that we discussed before in an enterprise network. So usually when we do on-premise deployment, what happens is it does not allow you to collaborate with external parties. And also due to this internal API management on-premise deployment, it helps us to address some of the security concerns that we come up with daily basis. So we'll discuss about them in detail. So this is a typical on-premise deployment. As you can see here, we have all six components. And we do have our delivery channels or clients who are using this API. And as you can see here, our delivery channels, API management solution, and backend all reside within the same enterprise network. So there's no any outgoing traffic or any connection to outside world. All the traffic and traffic movement and deployment, everything happen within your enterprise network. Okay. So if we take this version of the on-premise deployment, it is slightly different from the previous one. So in this case, we will have API manager deployment within your enterprise network. At the same time, we are exposing a set of components to outside world. For example, if you need to expose your store and gateway to outside world and let them to communicate with this gateway and let them to use your APIs and services, you have to expose that using a load balancer or reverse proxy, as you can see here. OK, so if we discuss about advantages of on-premise model, like you can see here, you have complete control of your deployment. So in this network or in this deployment, all servers, network, routers, all the complete deployment belong to you. So you have total complete control over this deployment. And also it is somewhat easy to do the integration because your backend system and your client applications or delivery channels, everything reside within the same network. And also it will reduce the latency of traffic because backend system and API management solution reside within a close proximity. And like I mentioned earlier, it also help us to keep your traffic within the enterprise approved boundary. And as like I mentioned earlier, it does not need any connection to outside world. And also with this on-premise model, we can continue message processing even if we don't have internet connection to or connection to outside world. So since we have a deployment within this enterprise network itself, we don't have to worry about external connections. So if we discuss about disadvantages, total cost of ownership would be a problem because, like I mentioned earlier, you have to maintain all the servers and network, and you may need to have skilled engineers to manage this deployment and do the deployment process as well. And also, like I mentioned earlier, somewhat difficult to collaborate with external parties, and there can be some kind of security risk associated with this one. And also, it is somewhat difficult to implement disaster recovery or failover deployment. Because this deployment done within your enterprise network, and you cannot simply take a copy of this one. If this deployment goes down, there's no way to you can easily recover that. So those are major disadvantages with on-premise model. Okay, so now we'll discuss about the cloud deployment model. So in cloud deployment, we will deploy all six components that we discussed earlier in a cloud. So if we discuss about cloud API management deployment, there can be multiple versions of cloud deployment. So first one would be a private cloud, where you deploy your API management solution in a private cloud and use that for the private purposes. And also you can deploy your API management solution in the public cloud and expose that to the internet as a service. And also same way, you can use public cloud-based API management services offering, which is similar to our WSO2 cloud. So in such case, you do not have to worry about deployment, patch application, or anything like that. So all these things are taken care of by solution owners. So only thing you have to do is you have to log into system and create your APIs and use that. So there are different cloud versions, but we will discuss about advantages, disadvantages, and deployment methodologies in generally related to cloud. So this is a typical cloud deployment. So as you can see here, this complete deployment done on the cloud, and all the outgoing traffic will come through the internet. All the delivery channel reside within the internet. Will come through outside, and this deployment available in the cloud. So if we have some consumers in the cloud, they can directly communicate using the internal channel, but all the other requests will come from the outside. So in cloud model also, we have slight different variations of that. So sometimes you may have your backend systems which are deployed in on-premise deployment. So your API management solution reside in the cloud. Some of the backend services will stay in the cloud. But at the same time, some of the services will reside in your private data network or your enterprise network. So in such cases, we have to open some kind of a secure channel or some kind of a communication link to cloud API management solution to communicate with those services. So then only those services can expose to outside to the internet using the cloud API management solution. So if we discuss about the advantages of cloud API management solution, main advantage is it's cost effective. So since we deployed everything in the cloud, we don't have to worry about patch application and deployment management. All this stuff we don't have to worry about most of the time. And also it is somewhat easy to manage. Infrastructure management done by the external parties. And also, if you go for the public API management solution service as a service offering, you don't have to worry about patching, updating, or anything like that as well. And also with this cloud model, it's very easy to implement disaster recovery or failover solution. For example, if you have your API management solution in US region, and you can have the same copy of this one in the Asia Pacific region, in Africa region, and different regions. So if any one data center goes down, you can survive with other data centers. So likewise, with the cloud model, we can get those advantages as well. So if we discuss about the disadvantages, first thing is it is somewhat inefficient if your clients and backend services both reside within the same network. Because in this case, client have to go through the internet to the API management solution, then come back to your local services or data exposed in your organization. So it will add some additional hops, and also it will introduce some additional latency for your API calls. So it will be somewhat inefficient if you have clients and server both in your local network. And also, with this model, you will have to expose your data and services to internet. So sometimes that can be a problem, because if you have some sensitive information, your company policies and your security may not allow you to expose your data to internet. But we do have different solutions for each of these as well. We can open a secure secure channel or secure tunnel kind of thing, and we can address them. But in generally, these are made major disadvantages of this model. And also, if you have some regional sensitive data or data that you cannot route through the internet, it will be also a problem with this model. So with basic understanding about on-premise and cloud deployments, we will move into hybrid API management deployment. So with hybrid API management deployment, what we are trying to do is get the advantage of both on-premise and cloud deployment and build some kind of a hybrid solution. So usually, when we do hybrid cloud hybrid API management solution, what we will do is we will deploy a set of selected component in the cloud and a set of another selected component in the on-premise or regional gateway. So usually, when we do regional or on-premise gateway, we will select API gateways, because API gateway is the most critical component and mostly used component in API management deployment. And most of the time, we will have to scale API gateway. So that is why we mainly focus on the API gateway. So this is a typical hybrid API management deployment. So as you can see here, we have all six components deployed in the cloud. And we will have two copies of gateway in your enterprise network or local network. So with that model, your internal delivery channels can communicate with the API management solution gateways available in your enterprise network and directly consume backend. So with this approach, these delivery channels do not have to go all the way through internet. And also with this one, like I mentioned early, we can implement disaster recovery and failover kind of implementation using the cloud solution. At the same time, get the advantage of on-premise API management deployment. OK, so when we do API manager gateway deployment, we do have multiple options. So we can deploy API gateways in a private jet mode, or sidecar mode, or centralized API gateway mode. So these are main three deployment methodologies of gateway. So if you deploy API gateway in regional or on-premise deployment, most of the time you will have to deploy your gateway one of these three patterns. So first one is the private jet mode. So with private jet mode, what we will do is we will deploy API gateway per API basis. So let's say you have 100 APIs in your cloud system, and you will going to use only one API from them in your enterprise network. What you can do is you can get one of that API and deploy that as a dedicated API gateway in your enterprise network. So you don't have to take all the APIs that you have in your cloud system. So that is what private jet mode. And next mode is the sidecar mode. In sidecar mode, what we will do is we will bind two or few atomic processes, and we can run them as a single runtime. So in this case, what we will do is we will bundle a healthcare-related API and gateway along with the service. So when you scale the service, you don't have to worry about scaling API gateway, because each time when you scale this, you are scaling both gateway and backend runtime. So if you work with Docker and Kubernetes, this is somewhat similar to pod. So when you have a copy of that one, you are scaling both these servers. So next mode is centralized API gateway. So centralized API gateway is the traditional API gateway model. So with that, what we will do is we will get same copy of API gateway that we have in the cloud and run that in your enterprise network. So with that, we will have all the APIs that we have in the cloud in your local deployment as well. So there are different advantages and disadvantages with both these all these approaches. So for example, if we take this deployment method, this gateway would be a little bit bulky. And when you scale this API gateway, you are scaling all the 100 APIs in the system. So there are different advantages with this one. But at the same time, if you have APIs that are getting like 10 to 20 requests per day or very less TPS, so in such cases, there's no point of having dedicated API gateways for this kind of services. So in such cases, you can go with centralized gateway. So same goes with sidecar and private jet mode as well. So there also, we have different advantages and disadvantages. And we'll discuss a little bit about multi-cloud as well. So multi-cloud is not directly related to hybrid API management, but it is a slight variation of the same deployment methodology. So in this case, we have all six components in cloud. And at the same time, you can have regional gateways. For example, if you need to have some kind of deployment in Asia region, you can deploy API gateway in Singapore data center with the Amazon services or Azure or Google Cloud. Likewise, you can have different cloud-based API gateways across the world. So with this one, then first we will discuss about multi-cloud integration. Then even within this one cloud, we can deploy gateways within multiple regions. So you don't have to worry about downtimes or if you have some, for example, if you have some backend in your Google Cloud, and you may need to deploy gateway in a Google Cloud. At the same time, you may have some set of backend in your Amazon. At that time, you will have to deploy your gateway in Amazon. So likewise, you can do multi-cloud integration as well. OK, then we have basic understanding about hybrid API management deployment. And then we will see what is the role of microgateway in hybrid API management deployment. So first, we will see what microgateway is. Microgateway is secure HTTP-based lightweight message processor for API. And most of the time, microgateways may have full features or subset of features that API gateway is having. So in our case, we do have microgateway, which offers subset of features available in the API gateway. And also, these microgateways are natively support microservices architecture. And it fits very well with the microservice architecture. So when we deploy microgateways in regional or on-premise deployment, we will have to face some of the challenges. So some of these challenges are like this regional on-premise deployments may have servers which have less resources. Sometimes we will have to deploy this micro gateway in IoT devices, and we do not have all the luxury that we have in the cloud. So we have less resources, and startup time is critical. So when we have that kind of requirement, when we deploy gateway, they should consume very less resources. So that is key requirement when we deploy on-premise deployment. And also, if you start this stuff in lockdown environment, which do not allow any internet connection or something like that, this gateway should be capable to process messages offline without connecting to internet. So that is also another requirement. And also, unlike cloud deployment, sometimes this regional on-premise deployment done by the external parties or third parties. So in such cases, configuration management and DevOps related tasks would be somewhat difficult. So when we deploy gateways in such environment, configuration management should be very easy, and it should be DevOps friendly. And those characteristics should be available. So microgateway fits very well into hybrid API management because microgateway address most of these concerns. And that is why microgateway fits very well in the hybrid API management deployment. Okay, so next we'll discuss, so this is about how Microgateway fits into hybrid API management. Like I mentioned early, lockdown environment, it works very well. And with this approach, you can deploy gateways anywhere if you are using Microgateway. So because it can run on your IoT device, it can run on your local workstation, and it can run on cloud. So it can run on anywhere. So with this approach, you can run Microgateway anywhere, literally. Then we'll discuss about WSO2 API Manager Microgateway a little bit. So from API Manager 2.5 release onward, we will offer you a Microgateway toolkit, which allows you to generate a Microgateway runtime. So this Microgateway completely complete designed to fits to microservice architecture, and it is completely developer centric, and also it consumes very less amount of resources. For example, if you take memory usages, it's less than 200 MB, and it is start within less than second, 1 second, and it is DevOps friendly. And it does support horizontal scaling and elastic scaling. And this gateway is designed in a way it is immutable and ephemeral. So you can run that in a short period of time. And you don't have to worry about hot deployment, deployment synchronization. So any of these things, you don't have to worry about that. Because each time when you deploy the gateway, it's an exact new copy of the available system available in the API management solution. And also, in-memory metadata and no database connection required at all. And also it is configurable at deployment time. So 2.5 release onward, we do have all these capabilities. Now let's see how it works. So during the demonstration, we will after the launch, we will go into detail and we will show you how you can deploy this deployment completely. And for the moment, let's see how we can work with the Microgateway. So we have Microgateway toolkit, and it can generate the Microgateway artifact. Then you can deploy them per API basis. And also at the same time, it allows you to generate Docker and Kubernetes runtime. You can generate the images, and you can run them. OK, so I think with that, we can conclude the session today. So during today's session, we discuss about different deployment methodologies and advantages and disadvantages of each. And we discuss about the hybrid API management and how our Microgateway fits into that solution. So thank you very much, you all.